Check out channelfireball.com to step up your game with videos and articles from the best in the world. You can use the code Gaby at checkout to help support this channel. Hello everybody on YouTube and welcome. We are drafting the Core Set Cube. It just came out to Magic Online today? Yesterday. Maybe it was yesterday. You cast mana as though if there were windings, add a bunch of mana, draw a card for each color among permanents you control. I don't think we want that. I'll pick it up if I remember, Slew. It's just a matter of remembering to do it. I'm happy to get the game. The beginning of your upkeep, you draw X cards and you lose X life or X number of zombies you control. You like tree or fireball? Add one mana of any color. Huh, I do like that. That's a good start to end up in some, like, multiple colored bullshit. Oh, I remember Triplicate Spirits, too. That was, like, from N14, I want to say. I'll take Utopia Tree. That sounds Gucci. Lily Nexus is in the cube? Ooh. Wild Growth? I don't think I want what. Merfolk Looter. Are we going to go Golos? Maybe. We'll see. Platinum Angel? I don't know about Platinum Angel. I don't think I want a Jace's Phantasm. There's no good green cards here. No, I don't want to take Nexus. It sounds so fucking boring. Why don't we just take Merfolk Looter? Merfolk Looter just seems like a good card. Pop Tart Mini! Thank you for the 19. Woo. Could take Wild Growth and stay on target. Can it land is tap for mana? Its controller adds an additional green. All right, I'm in. Look, we're going to cut out green from this pack and then we're going to be green faux show. Hey, T-Dog. Welcome. How goes it? Ooh, I love Rewind. Seedborn Muse, untap all permanents you control during your each other player's untap step. So it's like Prophet of Crucifix, kind of. Heroic Intervention, permanents you control gain hexproof and indestructible until end of turn. I don't think I want any of those guys. Could take Temple of Mystery. Seedborn seems okay. I kind of like the temple because it's, even if we don't end up in green, it's like an off-color fixer. There is an UG archetype. I mean, I guess Rewind would be good with that. Heroic Intervention seems like a blot. I'm just going to take Temple of Mystery and keep going this direction, I think. Oh my god, I used to love my boy Flynn of Board. You may play two additional lands on each of your turns. Well, it seems like we're drafting some sort of land monstrosity, so we could definitely just take Azusa now. Other options. Harambe Village. Not a ton of other options, to be honest. I mean, we could do something like Languish if we wanted to just be like black green control kind of. Is Treetail bad? No, Azusa's probably not good, Molly. I kind of want to take it just because I feel like it could do something cool. I could just take Harambe Village though. How many lands am I gonna have in your hand? Not that many, but we could try to draft a lands combo deck. We should probably just take Harambe Village. Cavalier of Thorns seems like a pretty good thing to ramp into. Land of War Elf seems like a good ramper. We're still not sure which direction we're going in. If we see good cards for something like Enchantress, we could try to go that route. This is a card for that, but I don't think it's better than like Cavalier or Land of War Elves. Scapeshift and FTDR in the cube, so that's the thing. That's true. I don't know if that really helps with Azusa though. Yeah, I think I'll take the Cavalier. Don't think we're wheeling this back. This card is okay, right? Enchanted creature can't attack or block. Activated abilities can be activated at the beginning of your end step if enchanted creature's powers 4 or greater, destroy it. Oh, I remember. That was in one of the like master sets. You could get blown out with it. Oh my god! I used to think, doesn't this vampire look like it's DJing? I've always had that idea in my mind. I always think it's DJing. Like, it looks like it's doing a set. And then at some point, somebody pointed out that it's clearly not DJing. And I'm like, I'm just going to ignore that. That is the OG heavy metal art. It's so cool. I don't think we want Overwhelming Stampede. It's just like crappy. I don't think I want that. Overgrowth is enchant land. Enchanted land is tap for mana. Controller adds an additional 2 green. I mean, at this point, we're like on mono green ramp, right? So you might as well. Search your library for up to 2 forest cards and put them on the battlefield and shuffle your library. I don't actually think we want that. We could take Vivictus. see if we can splash it. Would be kind of hard, but we certainly could try. It's a thick boy. Alternatively, we could take like... Yes, there is an Enchantress archetype. I'm just going to take this and see if we get to splash it. I don't know. Jund Dragon seems pretty badass. Oh, man. I remember having this card in one of my, like, EDH decks a bajillion, quintillion years ago. Charcoal Diamond enters the battlefield tapped and that's black. That can't be that bad. This card was interesting because it gives trample. I could see that card being okay. We could get blown out badly by removal. Really happy that they used that Sarah avatar art. This is the only one I know, Sam. This is the only one I've ever seen. I think I'll take this thing and just get blown out when they inevitably kill our creature. Wow, triplicate spirits came back. People don't respect it. Could take fireball now if we're just the go big deck and we're trying to play the Jund Dragon. Fireball wield. I'm surprised. It's like pretty good in our deck too. I mean, yeah, it seems good in this deck. Let's take it. So we could... Okay, Cone of Flame was so good. I just don't know how good it's going to be in this cube. 1, 2, and 3 to any target. We've definitely seen a different art for it, but now you can't find it. Maybe it was like a promo or something. I don't think I want Platinum Angel. I don't know. We don't really have any combos for it. Like, what's our idea? Just that we just play a Platinum Angel and hope it's good enough? I'll just take Cone of Flame and hope that's good enough. What is this? Enchanted creature gets +1/+1 for each other creature in the battlefield that shares one type with it. Oh, I remember this card. I don't want it, though. RG Ramp is an archetype in this cube. Yeah. We can take the Ranger's Guile, protect our creature that gets the growth on it. That doesn't seem terrible. I don't think we're playing any of these. I guess the most likely we are to play is if we somehow ditch red and end up in white. We are probably going to want God's Willing. I don't really know. Sigil of the Empty Throne came back. Oh, you found it, Sam? That's the only one I knew. We had it in... It wasn't even really good. I don't think it had any combos in the deck. It was just, like, in there. I'm going to take this, put it in the sideboard in case we end up being Enchantress. Target creature gets +7/+7 until end of turn. Well, this works with Enchantress, right? Yeah. So, let me put this here. Let me put that there. And I'm taking the God's Willing and the Sigil. And I'm going to put them over here in case we decide to go this direction. We can just keep it in mind. Stormwing Entity. I don't think we're interested in that. What is this again? At the beginning of your upkeep, you may return target enchantment card from your graveyard to the battlefield. As long as you control 5 or more enchantments, each other non-air enchantment you control is a creature in addition to its other types. Oh, I remember that card. Yeah, I don't think we're interested in that. Yeah, you can definitely ask Omega. I like Mindstone or Thrashing Brontodon. Oh, Sylvan Ranger is really good too. Search value for a basic land card reveal, put in your hand and shuffle your library. I kind of like having this as enchantment removal main deck. I'm not sure. I could see this being really good. I don't know. I'm just going to take the Mind Stone. Hey, Eva. Welcome. Dreamy, I wasn't trying to. Oh my god, I used to love Silk Sash Spider. Holy shit, this card was my jam. I used to love it. It was so cool. It wasn't even that good, was it? Deals X damage to each creature with flying. Yeah, it's not really that good. It's a 2/7. This is some real OG BG Garbo stuff. You're new to MTG. Any tips for deck construction? Standard 60 cards. I think the best thing I could recommend for you if you want to do some deck build is go look at some articles by people who've written about building decks, because those tend to be pretty good. I can shout out the sponsor of the stream, channelfireball.com. Here, check it. Thank you so much, Johnny. Wow, you're gas. Thank you. You have unironically played Silk Session of PTQ. It was so cool. I remember how badass this card was. I think I just want the Master of the Wild punt. I remember Trading Post being really sweet too. Oh my gosh, Corrupt. You know what? I will say that I don't know how good this cube is, but it's definitely giving me the feels. Let me sort by converted mana. Like, it has a lot of really nostalgic cards. Fauna Shaman is interesting. Oh, there's a door to nothingness. So cool. Okay, so we can cultivate our Thornwood Falls. You know, I actually won once with Door to Nothingness Unlimited. It was like the biggest accomplishment of my life at that point. It was so cool. It was really not good, Sam. Silk Slash Spider was like just a random rare we had in the mono green Stompy deck we had around. But I played it against this deck that had flyers. And so Silk Slash Spider was just a house. Like, you played Silk Slash Spider and then the other deck was just done. We have no blue cards. Why Thornwood? Because we could want it. I think we're probably just going to take Cultivate. Also, Ark has it right. We're always blue at heart is the thing. Oh, I love Sublime Epiphany. I don't think we're going that direction, though. We don't have that much that's drawing us into red at the moment. Probably just take Scavenging Ooze. I believe Reanimator is an archetype. Let me look. So we could just try to juke them. Yeah, we can also splash Fireball easily. Like, we don't actually have to play Vivictus and the Cone of Flame. But it's not like we have that much more stuff we want to take from here. Rootbound splashes Dragon. It's true. We wield Fireball. Look at that arc. We can always splash it. It's going to be easy to splash it. I'm going to take the Ooze because it turns out that Reanimator is an archetype. Ooh, do we have any combos with Roaring Primadox? Ooze doesn't do it. Tree doesn't do it. Cone of Flame doesn't do it. Cavalier doesn't do it. Ranger's Guile doesn't do it. Master doesn't do it. Okay, so we have no combos with Roaring Primadox. Oh, that's awesome, Danquist. I'm glad you enjoyed them. There should be some more cube videos coming out to the YouTubes. Yeah, I don't think we can play Darksteel Colossus. We're too far. I don't think we want that. Spectral Ward, huh? We can deck ourselves with Primadox and Cavalier. Wow, we did it. Listen, I don't know which way we're going. I'm just going to take the Yavimaya's Coast because I think there's a pretty good chance we end up being blue. Since it doesn't seem super likely we end up being Jund. Primordial Hydra. ETBs with X+1/+1 counters on it. Oh, this is a good payoff. Yeah. This is the one that lets you not attack, right? Island Walk, all lands are islands in addition to their other types. Creatures with without flying or island can't attack. Yeah, I remember that guy. Jungle Hall, what is this? Enchanted creature has flying, return Shimmering Winds to it. Oh, cool. So it's like a aura that protects itself, kind of. Yo, this Mindspring seems like it could be good in this deck. Groundskeeper, return target basic land from your graveyard to your hand. I don't think we're into that. If we did just want to keep going down this Vivictus Cone of Flame Fireball plan, we could just take Sarkhan. This is one of the good Sarkhans, right? No, it's actually not. Never mind, it's not one of the good Sarkhans. I don't want any of these cards. All right, we ended up with a Sarkhan. We didn't want any of them. Yo, Risen Reef. Yo, Zendikar's Royal. Hold on. Whenever a land enters the battlefield under your control, create a 2/2 blue elemental creature token. If we get that in like Scapeshift or something, that would be kind of cool. We have the Risen Reef Cavalier combo. Oh, that's so good, actually. Yeah, that maybe the Primadox will come back. There's Wood Elves too. We probably actually just want Wood Elves. Maybe there's no way this comes back, right? Hey, Lebrontodon came. Yo, Starfield Onyx came back. We could try to be Enchantress. Hold your horses. If we get rid of this, but keep that. And add this. And this. There. And Starfield of Nyx. Nah, it looks shitty. Let me take just this guy. Yo, Silk Slash Spider's back. Yeah, I wanted to see what it looked like, Wahoo. I think we can say goodbye to all the white cards. I think that ship has sailed. Demonic Pact. That card is cool. I don't think it works here, though. We could honestly just take the Temple of Malady to try to make the Vivictus happen. Like, I don't actually think Silk Slash Spider is very good. I'm sorry, Silk Slash Spider. Please don't take it personally. Yeah, Tamodachi! Welcome. Temple of Milady. How dare you? On Silk Sash Spider? I'm sorry, Molly. I'm just calling it like it is. I'll take Thornwood Falls in case we do end up splashing for blue. I'll take a Hurricane for the sideboard. That actually seems like a good sideboard card. Hey, came back. Oh my god, no. The Primadox came back, but we're not going to get the Risen Reef back. Fuck. All right. Just... Oh, I'm so sad. Oh, I'm so sad. Fudge. What? Bribery's in this cube just seems so, like, overpowered for all the other stuff we've been seeing. Primeval Bounty. Whenever you cast a creature spell, create a 3/3 beast. Whenever you cast a non-creature spell, put a +1/+1 counter on target creature you control. Whenever a land enters the battlefield under control, you gain 3 life. I remember playing that card. Wasn't that card decent? Blanchwood Armor, though. Let me see. Enchant creature, enchanted creature gets +1/+1 for each forest you control. That does seem really good, too. I kind of want to protest and not take bribery. Fuck that card. It looks like we can't press bribery. No, I beg to differ. I think we can absolutely pass bribery. I don't want to take it. It's so stupid. I don't like playing with that card. Yeah, exactly, Will. I protest. I'm going to protest, and in protest, I'm going to take Primeval Bounty. Let's do it. Nexus of Fate is in the cube. I saw it in pack one, pick one. I also hate that card, so I also didn't draft it. Rexage looks awesome. If we are going to be a red deck, we could play Lightning Bolt or Thundermore Helikite. This is my boy. That card's my boy. Oh, shoot. There is opportunity in this pack. We have a lot of free blue splash. We got Temple of Mystery, Yavimaya Coast, and Thornwood Falls. It's double blue, though. We have to move into blue big time if we take this pick. Card draw is really good with ramp. All right, so since the Sarkhan does look pretty awful, the Cone of Flame doesn't look super good, and the Vivictus looks medium. So let's take the opportunity, and now we're just going to move into green this last pack. Or blue, excuse me. Yes, if I protest bribery, we're obviously going to get bribery, right? I think we should take the Plow Under. I didn't recognize it because the art's weird. I was looking at the Jace's Ingenuity, too. I think this just looks better. Isn't Polymorph, like, pretty okay? Destroy target creature, it can't be regenerated. Its controller reveals cards from the top. Oh, that sounds a little sketchy. I don't know if I want that. I like... Shivan Reef is interesting. It is a red-blue duel for opportunity. Rejuvi is also really good. It works really well with our Primeval Bounty. And Visionary is good at just cantrips. I kind of like having Visionary. I think it looks like a little better on this curve. Dude, Rejuvi breaks on me all the time. I have trust issues. I think this was my preview card at some point or another. I can't really remember. Clone's pretty sweet. Dragon's Horde doesn't look like it works very well here. Mana Gorge or Hydra could be sweet too. Thorn Lieutenant could be okay in this deck, I think. Yeah, we have a couple options. Flixing. Ooh, yes. If we're playing this Fireball, the Carplusen Forest looks quite good. And then we can also play a Mountain for the Cultivate. Yeah, I like it, Molly. I think we should play the Fireball. It seems very good in this deck. Carplusen Forest is like fixing. It is, indeed. Yeah, that was a responsible Molly pick. I like the Elvish Mystic. That just looks good. Oh. Nissa World Waker. This is a Nissa I am not familiar with. Oh, hello. Look at that Moss Diamond. Ooh, woo. Oh, shoot. There's a Banefire, too. I don't think we want to, though. Have you ever drafted Commander Legends yet? I have an Electrotal. How are you? It's really good to see you. Oh, this is just different art. I know this Nissa. We want this Nissa. We love this Nissa. Oh my god, I used to love Hornet's Nest. It's not amazing or anything. How have you liked Commander Legends, Electrotal? Not the bees. Whoa, we could fireball the Hornet's Nest. That's so cool. Do we have any other way to like fight with a Hornet's Nest? Or no? A little bit, Mephis. But I don't mind. These are just like normal corset art that they've put on here. I'm less familiar with them. I'm gonna take the Hornet's Nest and just like, just see what happens. Okay. Did a Commander Legends sealed IRL. It was very fun. Nice. Nice. That sounds really cool. I like the Voracious Hydra. That seems like a decent thing for us to. Oh, Hornet's Nest plus Master of the Wild Hunt. That totally works. Yeah, I love it. It's going to be great. I'm so excited. All the wolves fight it too because they all team up, right? I'm going to take the Hydra. Put it over here. Yeah, it does look like green was very open. I think we ended up in a good spot. Pyroclasm could be sweet for the sideboard if we ever wanted to board into that. I don't think we want the Hammer of Bogarden. Blood Health Caves, we don't need it. We don't need any of these. I'll take the booties. No, actually, I'll take the Pyroclasm. Swiggity swooty. Coming for your booty. I don't think we have that many elves, actually. Mephis, thank you for the gifted sub to Kellis. Thank you. I appreciate that. Oh, look. Glimpse of Futures in the cube. This card is cool. I don't think I'm playing any of these cards, so I'll take the Archdruid and just put it in the sideboard. Return all non-land permanents with converted mana cost X or less to their owner's hands. I mean, that could be okay. Seems better than pulling more. If I can put it in the sideboard. Mana Gorger Hydra looks Goblin Grenade. Sake Goblin. Nah, that doesn't really work. You have three elves. That's not enough to make it work, though. Rupture Spire to the side. Oh, I remember that card. Hey, we might play that. Yeah, the Mana Gorger Hydra, I think, is going to be in this deck. This is a little awkward. Do we want to play the opportunity? I can't tell. I feel like our fixing is decent. Heading out for a friend's birthday. Oh, thank you so much, Mephis. I hope you have a good birthday. Or your friend, rather. Whatever. I hope you have a good time. That's what I mean. We wheeled some good shit. All right, let me move these guys over. And also these guys. This is 25. We absolutely want the fireball. I am unsure about the opportunity. And I'm keeping the Hornet's Nest, Master of the Wild Hunt. Oh, the Primadox. The Primadox doesn't do anything in this deck, does it? We can just take that out. That's 24 and we can play 16 since we have a lot of fixing. We have six blue sources with one forest. So let me look at what are all the ways that we can fix for blue. Hey Darth, welcome. The mono deck Luis uploaded to CFB was hilarious. The win code was casting Infinite Command by bouncing Misty Sanctuary. That's the thing that they got into at the Mox Flubars. It's the same deck or something similar to it. Luis, hi Luis, how are you? Luis, I drafted a Corset deck. I don't really know what's going on here. I'm deciding whether or not this opportunity is worth. I kind of want to play it. What would we play? We definitely play Carpluzin. Temple of Malady we could play just as an off-color thing, but I think for that matter we might as well. Temple of Mystery. Yavimaya Coast. Harambe Village. Thornwood Falls. So that's 1, 2, 3 free sources plus... Wood Elves can get blue, right? Can it? Oh no, it gets a forest. And this doesn't a forest, right? No forest. Too bad, okay. Cultivate can get an island, so that's one. And that's it. Utopia Tree taps for any color. Oh, that's really cool, Ark. So we basically have five. If we put an island in here, we'll have 1, 2, 3, 4 plus the island, 5 with the cultivate, 6 with a utopia tree. Yeah, I want to play the opportunity. I think it's going to be good. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14. We can actually even add one more. Uno más. Like that. Are you supposed to play half-color temples in this format? I'm not sure. I have a couple of tap lands. I have Treetop Village and Temple of Mystery. Oh, shoot. My red is wrong. You're absolutely right. I can cut another forest for that. I do need a red source. And then we'll have for mountain, we'll have Carpuzan Forest Mountain, the tree, the cultivate. Yeah, that's good enough. Yeah, we have a couple of tap lands, Doko. Plus, we already have a temple. I think if we were just a green ramp deck, I would absolutely play the off-color land. I think it's worth it. I guess we'll find out. Yeah, I like that. That's a good heuristic chalice. I like it. Yeah, that's your two time twister. By the time we're playing Fireball, we'll have the red source. Like, it's not like we need it super early. Plus, we're still up to like 14 green sources. Like, that's a ton. I feel like it's not a huge cost to play those lands that we picked up. I just feel like these decks always get into the situation where they, like, ramp, 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 and they have, like, one big payoff, and then it gets answered, and then you're just like, oh, shit, everything else in my deck is just all ramp stuff and not that many payoffs, so I think having opportunity sounds nice, especially the sense of fixing seems okay. Scared of flooding with ramp lands? Yeah, a little bit. We also get to plow some fools. Yeah, exactly, Ark. Chad, how are your Thanksgiving preparations going? I know not necessarily people are going to go see people, but I assume people are still doing something for Thanksgiving. This looks pretty good. What dessert and those am I going to make? So we were chatting about it yesterday with Reptero. I believe we're going to make a blueberry crumble. And we also, it depends on whether or not we can get the stuff for this, but we were looking at making malasadas. Ooh, Ark, yummers. You made a bunch of ice cream for tomorrow. That sounds really, really good. No, Sam, did you get jebaited? The other place I mentioned yesterday will almost always have all the spices you need. I'll stall on this mountain. I don't think we need it yet. So, is it better to just cast this next? No, it's not. It's better to just do this and then cast Primeval Bounty next turn. Oh, nice. That's awesome, Sam. Oh, Luis, do you think we're going to get jebaited with our prime order? Dragon's Horde. This taps for any color for dragon, right? Gold counter on it. If you play a dragon, add mana of any one color. Removes a counter. Draw a card. We'll see, Mole. Mole! Oh, wait a second. I don't have enough, right? That's 3, 4, 5. Oh, no, that's... stupid. This untaps slight, right? Target land you control becomes a 4/4 elemental creature with trample. It's still a land. Untap up to 4 target forests. This costs 6, dude. That's my problem. So, I mean, maybe I just want to get it down anyway. No, I know I can play a land. I just wanted to... No, our problem's not counting to 6. I wanted to play this and then be able to play a land. But it doesn't seem like we get to. So I'll just play this and set up for next turn. Oh, because why? Because I could have also gotten Nissa Worldbreaker down. Like, I could have done this on 5, start attacking, and then next turn we do more stuff. I don't know. Oh, shit. They're gonna juke my forest. Yep. So when I cast a creature spell, I make a 3/3, and I also get as mana Gorgor Hydra. All right. That is pretty good against Overgrowth. It kind of juked me. We're doing fine, though. Let's always yield to this. All right. Well, I like our spot. Like, even if they're icing this thing every time, I have 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I draw land next turn, I can play Nissa. Star Compass. ETBs tap to add one mana of any color. Basic land that you could produce. They can produce a lot of colors. Yeah, that's true, Molly. That's a good point. I remember playing with this card. This is a long time ago. This was so long ago. It's like when I started playing Magic. Oh, it's basic land? Is that true? Any basic land that you could produce. Interesting. All right, they're still trying to tap my forest. My forest. Oh, shoot. I like that Scavenging Ooze can attack. That seems legit. Hey, Cal. Welcome. Imagine thinking APA had good fixing. Yeah, I kept the Hornet's Nest in. It's such a cool combo with a Master of the Wild Hunt. I couldn't gut it. It's obviously just a better sideboard card and good against aggro. Oh no. Don't wrath me, yo. Confiscate. Enchant permanent. You control enchanted permanent. Oh, wow. That is some bullshit. Sure. They are just so dead, though. Yep, they are. They really just are. There's nothing in the yards, right? Tapping my Mana Gorger Hydra. Sure. Voracious Hydra. Does this do anything special? Fight or whatever. All right. This does untap, right? Okay. Nah, we're just gonna prodigious growth. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Is that six? Yep. Elvish Mystic, you are the chosen one. Love it. Alright, so they can't steal my enchantment, which would be bad. This is return all non-land permanents with convertible cost X or less to their owner's hand. That could be good if that's their plan, but I also feel like... Okay, the Hornet's Nets look bad, though. It looked awful. Let's cut it. What is a reasonable thing to bring back in versus that? We didn't see any flyers. We didn't see anything that Primadox is good with. Oh, that's true. The Confiscate gets bounced too because it's an enchantment. It's not like... Oh, that doesn't do anything then. Molly, you know, sometimes I just like to live in a world where I can pretend that the Hornet's Nest is good. I don't know why you have to try to break it to me every time. Return target basic card from your graveyard to your hand. I don't think that helps. Hey, Viper Magus. Welcome. We do have the Lebrontodon to break up the Confiscate. I guess I could just play the Elvish Archdruid. I just need something to put it back into this deck that is in the Hornet's Nest. Yes, our sideboard is bad. They did seem like they could have a lot of flyers. This is also each player, so maybe we can call... It's like a second fireball. All right, I'm in. You don't have to convince me. We're in, baby. Yeah, this looks okay. I need to read this card again. ETBs with X +1/+1 counters on it at the beginning. Oh, wow. We drew the other side of the combo. So sad. This animates for 2. Okay. Let me just play that. We're not playing anything yet. So I guess step one is going to be Mana Gorge. Ooh. I think I'd rather play Mana Gorge and then next turn we can... play something else. I don't know. Getting this out first seems better. Inigo Montoya, thank you so much for the 12. Welcome back, friend. I appreciate that. No, don't. No, no touchies. Don't touch it. Flames of the Firebrand. Wow, I got mega juked. So, If we do go Carplusen Forest and then this, we can enchant this to play Elvish Visionary, which seems okay, right? We burn one, but maybe we get enough. Oh my god, the hurricane. Sup? Hey, BK. BK, look at all these bangers. Do you remember these in our Stompy decks? It's so cool. God, they always have the Icy Manipulator. Mother. All right. At some point, we won't get juked by it, I guess. 1, 2, 3, 4. I guess it's Master the Hunt time. Master the Wild Punt. How are you doing, Bukizel? What you up to? You never forget a Corset Hydra. Yeah, I remember them too. Did I see that there's a commander in Commander Legends that brings back mana? Are you serious? Are you for real? That sounds really cool. Oh, what do you know? They're tapping my Overgrowth again. Get in there, boy. Thornwood Fall seems sweet. No, Nissa World Waker. Damn. For shame. Am I gonna play in the boxing league? I probably am not. Electrotal. Commander's just not really like super for me. I've done a ton to work on the project, you know? I'm excited about, ooh, they confiscated it. Well, we drew the Lebrontodon, which is nice because, yeah, of course. Oh, actually, Electrotal, I am waiting on something for you, if I am not mistaken. I believe I am waiting to hear your address. I need your address. That's what I need. I need your address to get this shipped out to you. Thank you. What is this? Your luck? Oh, I'll check that out in a second. Wait, do we have lethal? We attack with everybody for 5, 6, 7, 8. And then we just hurricane for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, snap. We do. That does look like lethal to me. All right, so let's go to combat, attack with all. Wow, look at this hurricane. Really delivering. I don't know if there's something that might make us pay one or something, but I'm going to play it safe. I'm going to play it safe. That was so cool. Boop, 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 doo, doo, doo. Force Spike is in. Okay, well, they didn't have Force Spike up, but I'd just rather play it safe. I don't really know what's in the cube. And I don't know if there's any free counter spells or something. Oh, I have tied games before with Hurricane Molly. I'm going to keep... Don't judge my hornet's nest. Yo, I remember when Hornet's Nets got printed and people thought this was it. This is the coolest card that had ever been printed. So cool. Look at all the combos you can do with it. And it was just bad. It was bad. Hey, son, GG's. Sorry about the rude hurricane at the end. Yeah, I agree, Electrodoll. I want to believe, but it's really not that great. Oh, that sounds horrible, Sam. I remember that you would put it in decks with, like, fight effects so that you would fight the Hornet's Nest to, like, a Pelucranos or something. I believe those were in the same format. Black Maul. Or Mail. Target player reveals three cards from their hand, and you choose one of them. That player discards that card. Oh, no. Okay. Well, we're gonna show them the Hornet's Nest. We can show them the Lebrontodon and the... What I really want to play is the Wood Elf. So I have to show them the Lebrontodon and the, like, Primordial Hydra or something. So I think it's these three. All right, that's our choices. I just need the wood elves. I need it so bad. Yes, Molly, we're on the same page. We're totes on the same page. You have a nearly unbeatable one. Your opponent died to your juggernaut during a mindslaver turn. How? How does that happen? How did that happen? Wood elves. You're probably going to get a red source with this. Oh, no, I can't. This is forest. Oh! That's so cool. So you just don't block. Oh my god, that's amazing, Louise. You're such gas. All right, next up is Cavalier of Thorns. Try to cast this Hydra for as big as we can. Yeah, I forgot that the Juggernaut is forced to attack. I mean, that was Sam's story too, but I just spaced. Let me play this Cav. That's really sweet, Electrodoll. I've had multiple times that I've lost games of like Commander-ish or formats like that, where my opponent indestructible to all their stuff. I do not want that. And then Geddened. And I didn't have any lands afterward. Got him, Luis. That's so sick. I'm proud of you. Not that you need like a reminder. You're obviously like the first person to catch it, but it's so sweet. Yeah, classic Boris Charmin to Geddon. Hornet's Nest looks like it's its population is healthy here. That's it, Molly. What more you want from me? Oh, my opponent's mana screwed. That's too bad. Yay, slam dunk. Molly's not buying it. He thinks I'm full of it. All right, it's time for Primordial Hydra to go ham. Like, they either deal with my Hydra, or maybe I could just play Elvish Visionary. Oh, man. I think it's better to slow roll this, right? So let me just play this first. They have to deal with my Cav or they're in a lot of trouble already, so. What kind of beer am I drinking? It's juice. It's Spindrift, sparkling water. Nothing that exciting. Plow Under. Oh, no, my Plow Under went to the yard. That's too bad. Whatever. Here we go. Draw two cards if you control no artifacts. Discard a card. Sure. It is exciting, Johnny. This is a Raspberry Lime Spindrift. They died. Wow. I gave them extra info by playing the Hornet's Nest, by the way. So they didn't play anything. Hurricane back in. Hornet's Nest out. I can't keep this one. No, that was previous match, Destiny. I'm gonna mull. This looks good. I can send back that island. Or maybe I don't need the Thornwood Falls, actually. I can keep this and send back Thornwood Falls, keep Temple of Mystery, and then I can go Scavenging on 2, Thrashing Brontodon on 3. Yeah, that seems decent. Yeah, that looks good. Oh, you're right. I had revealed it. No, Destiny, you're totally right. I revealed it to blackmail. I was getting blackmailed a lot. I'm going to bottom anything that is a land. Overgrowth. Huh. I could just play this on 3 and play Cav on 4. I'm going to bottom it. I don't think it's that good. Yeah, I think I'm just going to send it down. It feels like we have a lot of mana already. I don't think I need another 2 more. I think you can force UG in this cube every time. Oh, yeah, I saw your tweet, Kate Scroll. About forcing Ubu. Or counter spells, rather. All right. Given that we've drawn Cultivate, I feel really good about bottoming that thing earlier. Feels good, man. Jules! I know, Synth! Hornet's Nest was ready. Remove soul, my scooze? Bummer. Now I will cultivate next turn, though, because I do want to play this soon. Gosh, my scavenging ooze was going to have stuff to eat from the yard, too. Sphinx's tutelage. When you draw a card, target opponent mills two cards of non-land cards are share a color were milled this way. Repeat this process. That's a little sketchy with a Cavalier of Thorns, but we have the Lebrontodon to clear that out eventually, so... Does look like they're going for the deck damage plan. Let me go 1, 2, 3. I think we just want to get Forest at this point. Put Forest in play. Look at this beautiful mana. Okay, we milled Fireball and Plow Under. Plow Under would have been a good draw. Bummer.
Julie! I need you to chill. Jules!
Chill the hug. Hey, dog. You wanna say hi?
Hi, I need you to chill. It's okay. There's no intruders. It's all good, dog.
I think we want to jam, even though this looks like they might have a counter spell. Not even that big a deal if this gets countered. I really want to resolve Primeval Bounty. Oh, that worked. Elvish Visionary, Wild Growth, Nissa, World Waker, and Hurricane go to the yard. It's too bad. All right, so the next turn we can go Primeval Bounty. We hit Mox Diamond and Treetop Village. So next turn we can go Primeval Bounty. No! Well, there goes our plan. I guess our new plan is just to Lebrontodon away this tutelage because we have 19 cards left. Maybe try to win on the back of this Cavalier. Oh, hello. If they have some sort of 2-mana creature counter and it's not Remove Soul, they're going to have to kill those Sphinxes, the Lebrontodon. So I think I just want to lead on this. Oh. I think we do want to boop it. I don't really want them milling me anymore. We're at 18. Yeah, that was stupid, Nether. I hate it. It was dumb. Talent of the Telepath. Target opponent reveals the top 7 cards of the library. You may cast an instant or sorcery card from among them without paying its mana cost, and player puts the rest into their graveyard. Spell Mastery. Do they have Spell Mastery? If there are 2 or more instant and or sorcery cards, they have instant or sorcery. Shoot. You may cast up to 2 instant or sorcery spells from the revealed cards. Oh, God. Okay, well, I'm glad we destroyed the tutelage. What did they... cast game log. Utopia Tree, Yavimaya Coast, Mana Gorger Hydra, Carplusen Forest, Voracious Hydra, Thornwood Fall Forest. They just straight up bricked. Taste it. Amazing. Yep, they did actually whiff. Okay, so now I really want to protect the Primordial Hydra, so we can keep that one up. Or the Cavalier. They don't have that many hits. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Ba, ba, ba. Turn off auto yields. Yeah, the plow. So, what hits did they have? They could have hit. Cultivate, Plow Under, Opportunity. They could have hit Opportunity, yo. Fireball, and that's it. We won the match. If they had hit Opportunity. Pfft. Yeah, so Plow Under we had milled earlier, luckily. Opportunity would have been bad, because then they would have just refilled. Oh, are we about to trophy? with Hornet's Nest in her deck, maybe. This Hornet's Nest has not done anything yet. It's been really, really bad. It's been truly heinous. Only 50% of Hornet's Nest. I mean, Hornet's Nest did get... It didn't get discarded, no. Opportunity with Tutelage. I think Opportunity is target, right? Card Opportunity. Target player draws 4 cards. Yeah, I remember you could mill people with it. So, we were down to 11 cards. I guess they could have opportunity'd us to get us down to almost decking, but I don't know if that would have been fast enough. Yeah, Chalice, we've played against some control decks, basically. You only really want it in creature matchups. I just really wanted to do the stupid Master of the Wild Hunt combo. Hello, my love. That dog is activated, yo. This looks good. We can go Falls, Yavin, Maya Coast into Mox Diamond. Yes, if it was still... Oh my god, you're right, NFC. If it was still in the board, we would have just died. So we gotta kick it off with Thornwood Falls. Nice, nice, nice. Boop. All right, I want to see what they're working with. Same to you, they said. Nice. See? Look at me now big-timing my opponents. Might as well just play this. Go 1-2. Nice, nice. Okay. Yeah, I know. Look at me, Penguin. I'm really crushing it out here. So if we go 1-2 to play a Mind Stone, then play a Force, we can also play the Lebrontodon. That seems kind of sweet. Because there's no way we need to blow up this yet. We can just kind of jam. And then next turn we can Opportunity. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah. One, two, three, four, five, six. Oh, I actually should have played my fort, my island, because I'm going to have to take a damage from Yavimaya Coast for this opportunity, but that's fine. Boop, 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 doo, doo. What is this? Necrotal, first strike. Destroy target non-artifact, non-black creature. That creature can be regenerated. That's too bad. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Woo! Wow, look at that. Holy moly. All right, we did a bunch of stuff. Let's figure out what we want to do this turn. They are super. I mean, we're going to definitely start with Plow Under. So we start with Wild Growth and put it on a forest because that's mana neutral. And then we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we can still play the Visionary. We should technically go Visionary then Plow Under. But honestly, like, there's no way I don't want to plow them. And then also play this into Visionary. Ho! We're getting there. Zathrid Necromancer. Whenever Zathrid Necromancer or another human creature you control dies, to create a 2/2 black zombie creature token. This has first strike, right? I don't really want to block that. Oh, we plowed them good. Are we still doing phrasing? Yes, that would count. I think this is a human. Human assassin. It looks like a skeleton to me, too. Let me start with Cultivate. Let's get a mountain and a forest in there. You got 4 votes in Commander Legends game? What did you do, DC? How did you angle for the good votes? think we're at a good spot to crack this Mox Diamond. So if I go this Overgrowth there. Oh, no. I'm doing it wrong. There you go. Oh, no. Actually, you know what? I don't think I even really want to Overgrowth. How much can we Fireball for next turn? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Oh, we're actually getting close. I just think we should play the Scavenging Ooze and start eating stuff from the yard. Because we can eat the Lebrontodon. And that blocks the Zathrid Necromancer. Yeah, I'm just going to play this. Oh, actually, Molly, you're right. We can't do it at instant speed, but we can eat once. Yes, you're right. All right, well. Yeah, there's only one thing to eat. I mean, there potentially could be more depending on what they do. Seems unlikely, though. It has to be a human that dies. Okay. You basically had a landfall make Doomblade. That sounds fun. You can't decide which one you want to do. If it helps you know, most people chose Commander Legends or Ikoria Lair of Behemoths. It was all between those two. Should I eat something from my own yard for my own sake? I don't have any sort of recursion, and I guess they maybe could have some bullshit, so maybe I'll eat the opportunity. Oh, hello. I don't really want to jam into what seems like they just have, like, probably removal spells in their hand. So, if I had, well, throwing out on Visionary into 4 open mana from a deck that's played literally nothing is not great, but I guess we don't lose that much by doing it either. Because the whole point is to Fireball them anyway. So maybe we go like this and go Overgrowth on you. We could also wait for them to tap out. This is true. I kind of feel like we don't have a rush, right? I don't know. I'm just gonna chill. Sounds good, Electrotal! Enjoy the Doge Walk. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna chill. They're not doing anything, and I have 2 really good cards in my hand that I'm kind of stalling for. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 minus 1. So it's 12 at the moment. How much time are we at? It's not about time. Oh, mana. Sorry. There you go. They tapped out. When Priest of the Blood Rite enters the battlefield, create a 5/5 black demon creature token with flying. At the beginning of your upkeep, you lose 2 life. Okay, now we're in a good spot to do the thing. So this costs 1 more to cast for each target beyond the first. So, the question is, do we just want to put this on the Visionary and jam and play Treetop Village, and then next turn we just Fireball all their face? Or do we try to actually split all this up? Yeah, I think I want to charge in with the growth. Let me put it on the Elvish Visionary. That sounds better. And then next turn we can attack with Treetop Village plus one no mas. Yeah, I really want the Fireball to go face too. Let me play Treetop Village. And we can attack with you. I think just you. Yep. It's awkward. This is a lot of damage. They could put the Demon, Priest, and Zathrid Necromancer in front. That doesn't really matter though, probably. Or rather, that probably nerd, that probably doesn't matter. There was a lot of probablys. I think we're doing just fine. That's true. We can also choose how we want to do some of this assigning of the damages. Because I don't think Necrotal is going to get in front of this. That would be kind of weird. They are just taking it. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, yeah, we can't do this yet. And we can't eat anything either. All right. We're ready for this fireball, baby. Are they just jamming? I don't mind to throw this here. Because I don't care if they get a thing. And I am happy to eat the thingy too. Oh my god. Oh, that's whatever. That could have been bad. I almost got scared. Time to go. This is going to be a fireball for a lot. Look at this. Pew, pew, pew. Got him. All right. So you know what card actually looks like it could be good in this matchup? Hornet's Nest, baby. Should we keep it in there? Because that's been the card we've been boarding out every time. Just because it's looked bad in every matchup. But this is the time for it to shine, right? This gotta be it. What else could we do? If we wanted... It didn't seem like Hurricane actually killed much of their stuff, so I don't think we want that. Ranger's Guile. We didn't see any removal from them, but they probably do. They're a mono black deck. Pyroclasm. Yes, Pyroclasm actually seemed good. Also, Pyroclasm kills the Hornet's Nest, eh? We definitely want to take out something. Honestly, the Prodigious Growth looks a little not great against the Mono Black deck. I think we can take that out. Zydroth, I think I want both of... I want the Pyroclasm and... ooh, okay. I can keep this. Do we want Cone of Flame? Cone of Flame is a little sketchy because it's double red and I don't have that much red mana. It works for Fireball because Fireball is like a spell we cast at the end of the game. Our All-Star's here, Molly. Are you ready? I hope you're ready. Hope you came prepared. I hope to choose Hornet's Nest. Choose Hornet's Nest. Choose Hornet's Nest. Please choose Hornet's Nest. Do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Please, 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 please. They're probably going to take Mana Gorge or Hydra. Fuck. All right, whatever. That wasn't even that big a deal. No. I know that we need red mana at some point, and we lost a Cultivate, but we can't take that right now. Ooh, Hypnotic Spectre, eh? Kind of want to get the Mana Gorge or Hydra going, because this thing's going to debate me. Random, right? Yep. I thought they were killing it. All right. Mana Gorge Hydra doing some work. Yeah, we might actually bring Hurricane in game 3 if they have a Hypnotic Spectre. We don't have a good way to deal with it at all. And guess what is looking not so good right now? We're gonna get gended out real good. They seem like they were mono black, Doko. No, they certainly could be some gent strategies. Sure. Come on, just bin forest. Just bin forest. Easy, just forest. Just do the forest. Please, please, please. That is awkward, but fine. All right, I want to go ham on this Mana Gorge Hydra. So what I can do is go... I can play Forest Overgrowth onto the Forest Elvish Visionary, and then I'll have Forest Hornet Nest and Unknown in hand. I don't really care if we've been the Hornet's Nest, which seems decent. And that also pumps up my Hydra twice. I have a question for me. What, Molly? How does a hornet's nest look now? Is that your question? Molly, I feel like what we're doing here is just a service to hornets everywhere because their populations are endangered. So, you know, it doesn't feel safe to bring a hurricane to the battlefield. Oh shit, Parney's streaming. That's so cool. Ah! Oh my god, if I played the hornet's nest, I was gonna get disfigured. Oh god. Alright, just been the forest. Just been the forest. Oh no. Yeah, I'm just completing the story arc for the murder hornets. They were a big part of the quarantine at the beginning. The beginning of the storyline, but you know. I'm really sad that we lost our hornet's nest. Well, next turn we can probably play all of our cards and then this hippie doesn't do that much. Yes, I agree, Ark. It was weird. It was like it's like one of those storylines that they start, but they just don't like really give them a good plot point. And then they don't have a good story arc either. Priest of the Blood Rite. Well, my Mana Gorger Hydra is pretty big now. Oh, snap. One, two, three, four, five. Play. I think maybe we animate a land, but we don't attack with it. Yeah, that makes sense because the demon can't do it anyway. So we can go this and to play this into this, and then we just have this become a 4/4, and then we attack with a Mana Gorger Hydra. They can't even block it. And if they just choose to attack Manissa next turn, they're in pretty bad shape because I have a bunch of power on the board. I have 12 power on the board. They found one of those nests and it had 200 queens inside. That sounds like straight out of my nightmares, Destiny. I don't like it. Oh yeah, this is a big boy. It's all grown up now. Okay, they are choosing to chump with a priest, mostly because the priest is all downside. Seems reasonable. They probably have to send the demon at Nyssa, but they're in such bad shape if they don't have a removal spell for the Hydra. Oh, yeah, that sounds like you feel Grave Titan incoming. How big of a deal is Grave Titan? It's a 6/6 and 2/2/2, so 10 power worth of stats. They can send. I think Grave Titan would be incoming, Molly, if they wouldn't be tanking about it still. Because they could easily send Demon to kill Nyssa and then have enough Grave Titan to not die. Because they can put Grave Titan plus zombies in front of it. Plus, like, maybe just take the damage from the forest or something. But the fact that they're not playing it feels like they have something different. Oh, that's true too, Time Twister. You're right about that. I guess it depends if we draw something that grows a Mana Gorger Hydra. Because then three tramples. Nah, they'd be fine. They would be fine. Maybe they have Grave Titan and don't have the mana. Maybe that's what's happening. Yeah, if we rip Fireball off the top, that works. We have the Utopia tree. We can do it for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Even more with Nyssa, if she's alive. Nope. They were off it. Wow, that was a very quick draft. Ba 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 ba. Freaking poggers. Everybody doubted our lovely splash opportunity mono green deck. Thank you, Polish. I appreciate it. All right, let me wrap up this draft, and then we're going to start a new one, yeah? I think so too, Molly. I think they had it in not land six. That seemed like a tilt, like, oh, why am I so unlucky? Sort of pauses. I can just read it for my Magic Online opponents. If you... I know! Hornets Nets 3-0, no big deal. If you're watching this on YouTube, thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed another Corset Cube of Phantom Draft League. I don't know that much about this cube, but I like trying it. It was very nostalgic. I like that part about it. I like this deck too. That was not bad. If you would like to support this channel, something super easy you can do is just subscribe. Let's you know when other videos come out and also help support the stream. Also, if you're shopping on channelfireball.com and you use the code Gaby, G-A-B-Y, that also directly supports the stream. Thanks for watching, YouTube. See ya. If you like this video, you can subscribe for more. And if you want to come say hi to us on the live stream, that's on twitch.tv/GabbySpartz. I stream every weekday in the afternoons, Mountain Times. See you later.